Photography therapy. This type of therapy uses photography to help individuals express themselves, develop self-awareness, and improve their mental health. It's worth noting that art therapy is a regulated profession, and that contains annotation. Therapists should be licensed and have a degree in art therapy. What is the difference between CBT-DBT therapies? Cognitive Behavioral Therapy, CBT, and Dialectical Behavioral Therapy, DBT, are both forms of talk therapy that are used to treat a variety of mental health conditions. Both therapies focus on helping individuals change negative thought patterns and behavior in order to improve their overall well-being. However, they differ in some key ways. CBT is a short-term therapy, usually lasting between 12 to 20 sessions. CBT focuses on identifying and changing negative thoughts, beliefs, and attitudes that are contributing to an individual's emotional distress. CBT aims to help an individual develop new, more adaptive ways of thinking, which in turn can help them to change their behavior. DBT is a longer-term therapy, often lasting several months or even years. DBT is based on the idea that some individuals have a genetic predisposition to emotional dysregulation and impulsivity, which can make it difficult for them to manage their emotions and behavior. DBT incorporates elements of CBT, but also includes mindfulness techniques, emotion regulation skills, and distress tolerance skills. DBT is often used to treat individuals with borderline personality disorder, but it can also be used to treat other mental health conditions such as post-traumatic stress disorder, PTSD, depression, and addiction. In summary, both CBT and DBT are used to help individuals change negative thoughts and behaviors, but DBT is geared towards more severe mental health issues, and it is longer. Thank you. 3 frame rate. This skill involves looking at a situation or thought from a different perspective. Reframing can help to reduce negative thoughts and emotions by changing the way an individual views a situation. Distress tolerance. This skill involves learning how to tolerate and manage difficult emotions without making them worse. Distress tolerance skills can include things like deep breathing, progressive muscle relaxation, and self-soothing techniques. This skill involves finding healthy ways to express and communicate emotions to others. Emotion expression can help individuals to feel heard, validated, and understood. Emotion prevention. This skill involves learning how to prevent negative emotions from arising in the first place. Emotion prevention can include activities such as regular exercise, getting enough sleep, and practicing good self-care. Interpersonal effectiveness. This skill involves being able to assert oneself and communicate effectively in person and professional relationships. Interpersonal effectiveness can help individuals to build and maintain healthy relationships and avoid or resolve conflicts. Modulation. This skill involves learning how to change the intensity or duration of an emotion once it has been experienced. These are some examples of the skills that can be used to regulate emotions. And it's important to note that these skills can learned and practiced, and should be tailored to fit the individual's needs. What makes an emotion negative, and why? Cafe selected emotion. Negative emotions are often considered to be negative.